Now to a 13 Action News exclusive. They are aiming to expand the possibilities of space travel. The crew of SpaceX's first all-civilian flight was here in Las Vegas to train for their history-making launch. 13 Action News reporter Jeremy Chen caught up with them, and he shows you what they went through to prepare.
The crew of Inspiration 4 was here at McCarran Airport to get a taste of space and also to show the world what's possible for private spaceflight in the coming months.
To boldly go where few people have gone before, that's what the crew of Inspiration 4 is aiming to do, to become the first crew of all private citizens to orbit the Earth. To do that, they'll have to get used to floating.
One of the things I'm most excited about with going to space is actually feeling that lack of gravity. And so getting a little taste today, I think, is really going to help us whenever we go to space.
To help with that, the crew enlisted the help of Zero-G, a company specializing in weightless flights. Local pilot Diana Klein flew the plane to help the crew prepare.
The crew of Inspiration 4 will get to feel a little bit what it's going to be like for 20 seconds at a time. So a total of 15 parabolas, 20 seconds of weightlessness each time.
Klein's flight was just one part of 3 months of training the Inspiration 4 crew has gone through so far. She says it's an honor to play a part in this mission.
And having that little glimpse of space that we land lovers usually do not get to see has been such a rewarding experience.
The crew sees this as a pioneering mission for civilian spaceflight that could open the door for more people to explore the cosmos like never before.
At some point or another, everybody is going to have an opportunity to go and explore among the stars.
They see their mission as potentially a Wright Brothers moment, with not just a desire to fly, but to fly on their own terms.
Space will not remain the exclusive domain of a handful of countries. Like, it's going to get opened up.
The crew will be launching no earlier than September 15 from the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Jeremy Chen, 13 Action News.